Who have you helped today? Hi there, I'm Dr. Carol. We are daily spending a few minutes talking about strategies to get through this season with less stress, fear, and anxiety. The COVID-19 pandemic is real, it is dangerous, and all of our lives are being impacted. But we're talking about strategies to move in a positive direction. There are things that you and I can do to move out of a fear mentality and to take positive action. Today's strategy that I want to talk with you about is help somebody. There is very little that will lift your spirits more than taking your eyes off yourself and looking for somebody else to help. Don't just do navel gazing and stay listening to cable news 24/7. Find somebody else to help. A very prominent psychiatrist, Christian psychiatrist in the last century, Dr. Carl Menninger, was asked, what would you advise a person to do if he felt a nervous breakdown coming on? And this was in a large gathering, and he was doing a question and answer session. And most of the people there expected he might say something like, well, tell them to go see a psychiatrist. But that's not what Dr. Menninger said. He said, I would tell them, lock up your house, go across the railroad tracks, find someone in need, and do something to help that person. I want to encourage you to do the same. Now, in our socially distancing world right now, use wisdom, seek the Holy Spirit's insight into what that might look like for you. But the principle is still there. Now, I am a physician, and healthcare workers all across our world are putting themselves at risk to help others. That is actually what the body of Christ has done for 2,000 years in the age of the church. Christians, followers of Jesus, help others, sometimes even at their own risk. Now, I am not asking you to put yourself at risk, but I am asking you to seek the Holy Spirit's input for what He would have you do. Just a couple examples of how Christians have stepped up in certain times in the past. In the old Greco-Roman world, where the early church got its start, it was not uncommon for people to leave unwanted newborn babies out to be exposed to the elements or for wild animals to get. Early Christians became known for finding the places where these babies would often be left and taking them into their own homes, raising them, adopting them, raising them as their own children at great expense to themselves, sometimes in extreme poverty, but giving them life. During the repeated bubonic plague epidemics across Europe, Christians were often the ones who would stay behind and minister to the sick and dying. It did become known at that time that if you stuck around, you were much more likely to get sick. So once the plague started in a certain town or city, often much of the populace would leave. The Christians were often the ones who stayed behind to minister to those who needed it, sometimes giving their own lives in the process. Whatever it is, you have something that you can do and give to others in this season. There is a lady in the church I'm a part of who has organized a neighborhood help group. There are, I guess it's over 50 individuals or couples in her fairly decent-sized neighborhood who she is organizing to help people when they're in need. If there is an elderly person or an at-risk person in their community that really shouldn't be out going to the store and getting needed supplies, they're arranging to help. Or if somebody needs some help to get to medical care or whatever it is, just helping those who aren't able to get out and do the things that they normally would. Maybe your kind of help can be some digital encouragement. That is real. We talked yesterday about staying connected, or a couple days ago, about staying connected with others during this season. Some of your intentional staying connected can well be put into connecting with those who really need that kind of encouragement. I have a friend who is the sole caregiver for her husband who has had a stroke. And I'm taking it upon myself to call and encourage her, even if there's nothing physical that at this particular time I'm able to do. Whatever it is, there is somebody who needs something you have to give. Find that person or group of people and be the hands and feet and voice of Jesus to them. Seek the Holy Spirit's input, use wisdom, but do lift your eyes off yourself and reach out and help someone. There's nothing that will lift your spirits more than doing exactly that. We'll have another strategy again tomorrow. And until then, may God bless you.